Hello everyone, in today's lecture I am going to discuss about the supernode analysis technique to analyze the electrical networks using the nodal analysis method. So first of all I will discuss why we need this supernode analysis method in place of the writing the ordinary KCL equations and solving the network using the nodal analysis, and how we can apply the supernode analysis technique to the special case of networks. So first of all, why we need this supernode analysis method? So this supernode analysis method is particularly applicable to the networks in which we have some voltage source which is connected between any two nodes in the network. So as we can see in this particular case, in this network we have node 1, node 2 and one reference node, and we can see between the node 1 and node 2 we have a independent voltage source. Now if I try to write the KCL equations for node 1 and 2 that we require in case of nodal analysis, then I need to write the current flowing in each and every branch. For this branch, this is a current source, this current is simply I. In this branch containing the resistance R1, suppose the current I1 is flowing. Now if I try to find the current in this branch where the voltage source is connected, so because we cannot apply any Ohm's law or any other method to determine the current that is flowing between node 1 and 2, it is very difficult to apply the ordinary node analysis method to this kind of networks. In case, in place of this voltage source, if we assume in place of this voltage source I am having some resistance, then I can easily determine the value of current using the Ohm's law, that is I is equals to this node voltage is V1 minus V2 divided by the resistance which is connected between node 1 and 2. But this is not the case now. We do not have the resistance, but we have the voltage source here, and we do not know what is the internal resistance of this voltage source, and neither it is given in the problem that what is the value of current flowing through this voltage source. So the one way to solve this kind of problem is we assume some unknown current, suppose IA, flowing through the voltage source VA. Now I will write the KCL equation at node 1. This will be equals to taking the incoming current as the positive and the outgoing current from the node taking as the negative. This will be I is equals to I1 plus IA. But now I cannot represent the IA in terms of node voltage, so this will remain as it is in my equation. Now again I will apply the second at the second node I will apply the Kirchhoff's current law. So suppose the I2 current is flowing in this branch and some current I3 is going in this branch. Now again, the IA is incoming to the node 2, so this will be IA equals to the outgoing currents, that is I2 plus I3. Now again I can express the I2 as V2 divided by R2 using the Ohm's law, and I3 will be equals to V2 voltage at node 2 minus this VB divided by the resistance of that branch, that is R3. But again the IA will remain as it is in the second equation. Now I will need to combine the equation 1 and 2 to eliminate this extra variable I. Then I will get a equation in terms of the node voltage V1 and V2 that I will solve to determine the unknown voltage. But this method seems too complex because I need to write some extra additional equations. Then I need to combine these equations to eliminate this unknown current I. So to avoid this complexity, we go to the supernode analysis method. So I have explained why we need this supernode analysis technique. By applying the supernode analysis technique, we can reduce our calculation steps and we can solve this network in very simple way. Now I will show you how we can apply this supernode analysis technique in such kind of network. So what we will do now, supernode is a theoretical concept in which we combine two nodes together, means we consider them as a single node, and the voltage source that is connected between these two nodes, for time being we ignore that voltage source. and instead of writing the individual KCL equations for node 1 and node 2, we consider it as a single node and we write the KCL equation for this single super node. So I denote this super node by this dotted lines. So this node 1 and node 2 I have combined to form a super node. Now I will so how will I write the solver circuit using super node? Combine the nodes containing voltage source as a single node known as super node. So after making the super node, what I will do? I will write the KCL equation, Kirchhoff's current law equation, at super node. So when I write the KCL equation for this combined super node, the idea is I am going to ignore this branch that is containing the voltage source. The other things I am considering as it is as we write the KCL equation. So starting from this node 1, the current I is incoming. I am taking the incoming current as positive and the leaving current from the node as negative. And from this node 1, the two currents are this current I1 is in the leaving direction, so this is I minus I. Now I will directly go to this node. I am not considering this branch I am ignoring because I have made a super node. Now coming to this node, there are also two currents I2 and I3 in the outgoing direction. So this is minus I2 minus I3 equals 0. Okay, so the algebraic sum of all the currents at a super node is equals to 0. Now the I is some constant, it is the current source value, so I will keep it as it is. Other currents I will express in terms of the node voltages. So this I1 I can simply write, if I assume the node voltage V1 at the node 1, so this will be V1 node voltage divided by the resistance connected at that node and the reference node divided by the R1. Similarly minus I2, I2 is the current flowing in the resistance R2 between the node number 2 and the reference node. So this is simply V2 divided by the resistance R2. And I3 is the current flowing in this branch containing the resistance and the voltage source VV. So this will be I3 value is the node voltage V2 minus VV divided by resistance R3. This equals 0. So this I get the simply first equation at the super node. And I reduce my stress, instead of writing the two KCL equations at node 1 and node 2 and then combine these equations, the same equation I am getting directly using the super node method. Now you can see, now we have in this equation we have if we rearrange, we will get V1 1 by R1 times V1, then plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 times V2 equals I minus, it will be minus and minus will be plus, I plus VB divided by R3. So this, after rearranging, I am getting this same equation. So let number it as 1. Now I can see I have two unknown node voltages, V1 and V2, and to solve this equation I need one more equation. So to get the second equation, now I will use this branch that I have ignored previously and I will write a constant equation using the voltage source between node 1 and 2. This constraint equation is nothing. This is the relation between the node voltages and the voltage source. So if we can see, this is the node voltage V1, here is the node voltage V2, and the potential difference between these two nodes, that is V1 minus V2, will be equals to the voltage source value VA. So we can write V1 minus V2 is equals to VA, that is nothing, this is the value of voltage source that is given in the problem. So this is my second equation in terms of V1 and V2. Now we can easily solve equations 1 and 2 to find unknown node voltages V1 and V2. So this is the method how we can apply the supernode analysis to any network. Now I will explain this same thing with the help of an example. So consider this network to apply the supernode analysis. So again in this network we have this node 1, node 2, node 3 and one reference node. And between node 1 and 2 we can see there is a voltage source. The value of this voltage source is 10 volts and all the resistances for the simplicity I have taken as the 1 volts. Now again we can see there is a voltage source between the node 1 and 2, so again I will make a super node using these nodes 1 and 2. This is my super node. Now I need not to write the separate equations, node equations for node 1 and 2, I will write only a super node equation. And this is a remaining node in the network, that is 3. For this I will write the another KCL equation. So first writing the KCL equation for super node. So let us assume some currents flowing in the branches. Let I1 current is flowing in this branch, and in this branch the current I2 is flowing, and this is the current I3, and this current is suppose I4. So if I start from the super node, because super node is a combination of node 1 and node 2. Starting from node 1, there is an incoming current of 5 amperes by the current source. So 5, the incoming current taken as the positive. And then I1 current is leaving. Then I will directly go to this second node. At the second node, also the current I2 is in the leaving direction, so minus I2. And this I3 is also in the leaving direction, equals 0. Now I will express all these currents in terms of node voltages. So this will be 5. Minus the I1 is the node voltage, let V1 is the node voltage at node 1 and V2 is the node voltage at V2, node 2, and V3 is the node voltage at the node number 3. So this is I1 is V1 node voltage divided by the resistance which is 1 ohms. Similarly, the I2 is the node voltage V2 divided by the resistance which is 1 ohm. I3 is the current flowing between the nodes 2 and 3. So this will be V2 minus V3 divided by the resistance in that branch, that is 1, and which is equals to 0. So solving this we are easily getting V1 plus 2V2 minus V3 equals 5. So this is my first equation for this supernode. Now I will write the another KCL equation for node 3. So at node number 3 we can see this current I3 is in the incoming direction. So taking it as positive I3, and then I4 is in the outgoing direction, so minus I4, and also there is a current source and the direction of this current source is leaving from the node and its magnitude is 2 amperes, minus 2 equals 0. Now again I will express the I3 and I4 in terms of node voltages. So I3 is again, we have already written in the first equation, V2 minus V3 divided by 1 ohm resistance minus I4 is the node voltage V3 divided by the resistance of that branch, that is again 1 ohm, and it is minus 2 is equals to 0. And rearranging this, we are getting V2 minus 2V3 equals 2. This is my second equation. Now because I have two unknown node voltages, V1, V2 and V3, I need three equations. So third equation I will write again using the same concept of the constraint equation. So if we see the voltage source that we have ignored, this is connected between node 1 and 2, and V1 is at positive side of this voltage source and V2 at is the negative side. So using the voltage source of 10 volts, we can write V1 minus V2 equals 10. This is the third equation I am getting. Now I can solve all these three equations, sorry, this is equation number 2, and we can determine the unknown node voltages V1, V2 and V3. So for this, we can find the value of V1 from this equation, that is 10 minus V2, and then we substitute this value of V1 into the equation 1. So I will be getting, in substituting the value of V1 from the equation 3 into equation 1, 10 minus V2 plus 2V2 minus V3 equals 5, or this will give us the V2 minus V3 equals 5 minus 10, that is minus 5. So this is the another equation I am getting. Let it, this is equation 4. Now I am having this fourth equation in terms of V2 and V3, and also I am having this equation, that is V2 minus 2V3, and then we can solve these two equations to determine the values of V1 and V2. So solving these equation to the 4, 2 and 4, so writing the equation 2 here, V2 minus 2 times of V3 is equals to 2, and then subtracting these two equations, this V2 is will be cancelled out, and we are having this V3 is equals minus 5, and here is minus 2, that is minus 7 volts. So V3 I am getting as the minus 7 volt after solving the equation 2 and 4. Now this V3 I can substitute in any of the equation 2 or equation 4 to determine the value of V3. So using this equation 4 and substituting the value of V3 as minus 7, I will get V2, and this is minus V3, and V3 is minus 7 is equals minus 5. So from here I am getting V2 plus 7 is equals minus 5, and this will give us V2 as minus 12 volts. The second node voltage we are getting. Now using the values of V2 and V3, we can substitute this V1 and V2 and V3 in this equation 1, to determine the value of V1. So using equation 1, this is V1 plus 2 times of V2, that will become minus 24 minus of V3, so V3 is minus 7, so this will become plus 7 equals 5. So from this we are getting is V1 as 22 volts.